defense does get the job done, and Erica Corath, the catcher, will go back, and Barnett will make her way to second. Always a tough play when the ball pulls the first baseman away from the bags. An inside-out swing. Look how far the guy goes to get the ball. Just a really good heads-up play there from Knight. Once, as a second baseman, you see the first baseman release all the way towards second base. Your only option is to hustle as quickly as you can to first for the out. Asia James, the batter for the Huskies now, senior lefty about the plate, 0 for 2 today. Ball bounces off Bocanio. Barnett will hold up at third, but steps closer to adding another run here for UConn late. Well, UConn's always looking to take that extra 60 feet anyway, but Bocanio doesn't get her glove turned around. Tries to just backhand the ball, pick the ball, so to speak. And as a catcher, any ball in the dirt, you want to lead with that glove, turn it over, face up, get your body in front of it, especially with the runner. Themselves with another one at third base. They are 3 for 5 today with runners in scoring position, so very productive. And that hit by Barnett, the first one, we talked about this in the last inning, that the bottom part of the lineup for UConn was hitless, but then the top half that had done all the damage. Well, now the bottom half bringing something a little late and a chance to try to tack on another run. Barnett at third. James at the plate. No time for the infield defense to check the runner at third base when you have someone with the speed of James at the plate. The ball's got to go to the plate right away or to first base right away. Any time spent checking the runner at third base is going to allow James to inch a little closer to first base and be safe. This is a challenging play for the infield of Boston College, just having speed at the plate, speed at third base. One, two, fouled off. Looking at UConn's numbers this year, Carol, it's pretty incredible.